Hello, this is the next video in a playlist that I'm calling Parameter Estimation, and we're going to look at complete statistics. So the definition is this: let T be a statistic, right? It's a function of our data, with T following this distribution, either continuous or discrete, where the parameter theta lives in omega, the parameter space omega. Let that F, so this density, be in this family of distributions, which is indexed by theta. T is complete for family script F if the expected value of every function of our statistic equals zero, and this for all theta, implies that our function g of t is equal to zero for all theta. And this is almost everywhere. So if this is true, but this is true except for like one point, then it's still true because that point has probability zero. So the probability that g of t equals zero is one, right? Because the probability of a point is zero, so it doesn't play a part. Example one, show that xn, the nth order statistic, is sufficient and complete when xi is from a uniform zero theta. The answer is, in sufficient statistics examples, that, and it's in quotes because I have a video titled that, we showed that xn, the nth order statistic, is sufficient for theta. Now to show that xn, the nth order statistic, is complete, we need the distribution of xn. And that deals with order statistics. Now I have a playlist called Order Statistics where we look at this. But here we're just going to assume that you know the distribution for the nth order statistic. So then n is here. F of x of n is 1 over theta, right? That's a uniform, 0 theta. Capital F is x over theta, and that's raised to the n minus 1. So that can be brought in here, and this is the density. And this is for xn between 0 and theta. Now, we assume this is true, that a function of the nth order statistic, is, you know, the expected value of that function is zero. And this is true for all theta. So this means that we take what's in here times the density and integrate it over all possible values, set it equal to zero. Now, notice that theta and n are not part of the integration. So we could multiply it over and divide it over, and then we get that this is still true. This is equal to zero. Now, if we take the derivative of both sides here, we're here, so it's just the derivative of this function, derivative is zero, zero. Now, fundamental theorem of calculus says that we just plug that in for our variable, and it's equal to zero. Now this is positive, so we can divide it over, and that implies that g of theta is equal to zero. So thus, the nth order statistic is complete for this family of distributions. Now the next example, I think, is a great example because it shows you how to prove a bigger theorem, which we'll discuss at the end. So let's let x be normal mu sigma squared, where mu is unknown and it's part of the real number line. Sigma squared is positive but known, so it's a known constant. We want to show that x, you know, that t is complete, where it's just the first observation. Now, since we're only dealing with a sample size of one, we're just going to call it x. So let x be x1. And then this is the density of a normal distribution. And then we expand this, so, you know, x squared minus 2x mu x squared. And that's what we get here. And since that's in the exponent, we can separate it. But the reason that we do that is this piece here is just a function of the x's, right? Sigma squareds are known constants, so the only variable is x. Here, this is just a function of the parameter, mu. And this is both a function of mu and x, right? And we write it like this because then it makes it easy to show that this acts as sufficient, right? And we also, and there's also another reason we do this. I'll show you in a second. So this is part of the exponential family, normal distribution. It's in quotes because I have a video called that. Now we want to assume that the expected value of some function of our statistic, so g of t is zero, and this is for all mu, then we must show that the function is zero almost everywhere. And we do that like this. So the expected value of g of t is this. So we plug in that times the density, integrated over all possible values. Well, notice here we could reparameterize this and call this eta or some other parameter. And then this becomes what's called a bilateral Laplace transform. Okay, so see this? This is in here, this is in here, this piece is in here, right? So what we did up here is actually we just combined those two in here. And then this is part of the Laplace transform. Some call this a two-sided Laplace transform, some call it a bilateral Laplace transform. Laplace transform goes from zero to infinity. Bilateral means we're also including zero to negative infinity. Okay. Commonly, it's Laplace is with the script L. The two-sided or the bilateral Laplace transform, you put a 2 in parentheses, or you just put a script B. Okay. But because this is a bilateral transform, Laplace transform, that equals zero, that implies that everything in there is zero. Almost, for all mu, almost everywhere. So you accept on a set with probability zero. But this is positive, we can divide it over. This is positive, divide it over. But so that implies that g of t is equal to zero for all mu, almost everywhere. So thus t is complete for mu. Now one big note here that I want to point out, this reference to the bilateral Laplace transform, you can use that to prove that the exponential family, statistics there in the exponential family, are all sufficient and complete, as long as the parameter space does not contain a non-degenerate interval. It must be a non-degenerate interval. And a degenerate interval means a point. So non-degenerate means it has to be an open interval. And so in the theorems it says, the sufficient statistics are complete as long as the parameter space is not a non-degenerate interval. And the reason is that's required in this. So if it's to go from a bilateral Laplace transform to here, the parameter space must be a non-degenerate interval. Anyway, well, that's all I have for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed that. I sure did. Please like the video and subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Thanks. Bye.